Why nothing ever happens in Sweden here? Nothing. You go, girl. No, I'm not a girl. I'm a queen. And I'm the Lord Queen. Girl is something tiny and small. Yeah, thanks. I love it too. It's broken though. I need to get a new one. It's like, it should have been like this originally, but shit happens. See? Queen! Lord! I'm actually a dude. I'm proud of being a dude. I just cross-dress because I like to express myself as a man in non-conventional ways. But I'm actually really proud to be a guy. Yes, I will. Thank you. Thank you. I couldn't see your name on the screen here. I can't see who I'm talking to because, yes, I will always keep doing my sets. That sounds weird, you know, but you get the point. I will keep being me, you know, always. That's a sad thing with cross-dressing today, that most people assume cross-dressing, everybody who is a cross-dresser is the same. Everybody's, you know, super sissification, into sissification and the sissy stuff. I'm not into any of that. I'm into, you know, everything with strength, power, divinity. And I'm not a submissive sweetheart, a tiny thing. I'm like big bear dude when I'm not cross-dressing. So that's why I call myself the queen. queen, you just don't give a fuck. Me hände aldrig någonting i alla fall. Varför ser man aldrig sånt här i Sverige? För? Jag är alltid i skogen när jag kollar efter. I have one person watching. Four likes, I have zero now, I have zero. Zero watching. Thanks for the likes. Stay hard! Yeah, I've watched a lot of Goggins videos. Even if you cross-dress, stay hard. That's never happened to me, but I have had the encounters, you know, like not encounters, but weird stuff happening to me, like when I'm in the middle of the deepest forest in Sweden, that I hear stuff moving around in tree branches that are way too big to be anything normal, and then you just hear stuff drop from the trees, you know, like big things that aren't supposed to fall down, like big branches, you know. And I instantly know, I can tell that's not natural, you know. So something happens here in Sweden too, you know, but it's not like in the USA, you know. In the US, it's always, when I watch these cryptid encounter stuff, it's so much. But here in Sweden, it's nothing. It seems to happen to people that never believes in it. That's no interest either. Or never even, you know, considered stuff like that being real. Sure enough, he caught it, and its eyes reflected this orange red glow. But not too long after being identified, that I was sure the creature I saw was much bigger. I asked him what the Mothman was. He thought for a moment, then he said it was a force of nature that we just don't understand. What?
Much better. The next day we were watching TV in the afternoon. a breaking news story interrupted the program. Apparently, there was a major pileup on Route 62.
I have 4 legs, but not one single person watching now. Yeah. I've only been on air for like 15 minutes.
My dad commented that it happened on the same route that we took home. If we stuck to our schedule and left the campground when we were originally supposed to, we very well could have been involved in that accident. He continued watching the news in silence before finally turning to me and admitting that he did see the marketing once. At least he bodied it. He and some friends were driving along Route 62. They were drivers. He knew it was a stupid thing to do, but they were just teenagers. Suddenly, a little creature started following them. No matter how fast they drove, it easily kept up. He said it was dark and that he couldn't make out its features. But he never forgot its large glowing eyes. He and his friends slowed down. Tragedies over the years. My dad believed that the Mothman was just an omen. How you interpret it is entirely up to you.
I want to travel to Pennsylvania. That would have been awesome. To see the actual place with the encounter of the Mothman. I've been interested in that topic or these topics since I was 6 or 7, actually. When I first started reading, spent so much time at the local library just reading about the Mothman encounter. Wanted to go to Pennsylvania ever since, but I'm afraid of flying. It's one of my phobias. So even if I had the money, I wouldn't go to the U.S. to Pennsylvania. I'm actually, to be honest, I'm fucking terrified of the hillbillies. Really, as a Swedish guy living here, they scare me. That's why I even make, you know, satire, and I make parody sketches on another channel. I do parody sketches where I actually make stereotype of the hillbilly redneck. I have like a love and hate relationship to that. I'm fascinated with everything with the South in the US. I've never been there, especially with everything related to weird encounters. It's like my huge, one of my main autistic interests in life. Have I gotten any comment? No. No, no comment. I believe I've not gotten any comment on my channel. Why is that, sir? Miss, I implore you to leave a comment on my channel. Or I will have to send the dogs on you. I know that.
And while I do have a story about that, I'll save it for another day. This story is something I believe in. Or
what resides in the woods? Big Daddy Bigfoot. It fixed my lipstick, man. It's fucked up. It's fucked up. Damn. It's fucked up.
Rocks and rubble.
Yeah, I bet this is the weirdest stream you've ever seen on a cross-dressing channel. I'm not actually admiring myself in the mirror, I'm just putting on, fixing the lipstick. I'm no girl, I'm a queen, man. Lord Queen. It's okay to write something, you know. It's okay to write something. I feel kind of jealous of the guys who always sees these creatures everywhere. Like, why not me? I'm like the biggest believer, man. Well, I'm not worthy. Damn, I'm really thick, you know, my thighs. My thighs are insanely large. Oh my god. It's like three hands in one thigh or something. Four, man. I do a lot of squats. A lot of squats, bro. This has only been on for 19 minutes. It feels like I've been on for like an hour or something. Qué raro, no entiendo. ¿Qué pasa aquí? ¿Qué pasa aquí? Un misterio. El efecto Mandela. El efecto Mandela. Sorry. Sorry about that. Sorry about that, man. Didn't hear anything because I'm doing more. If I can't do two things at once, I can never do two things at once. Yeah, my hair fucking stuck in a lot. There we go. Poor cringe and puzzled after seeing this. Yes, Park Ranger puzzled after seeing this. I hope it's something that blows my mind. My thighs are humongous, as you can see.
Oh, I mean, fuck.
The cell phone is like falling down all the time. I apologize for that.
Look at my thighs. They look huge.
Stay hard, man. Zero people watching, one people, one person is watching, nobody leaves a comment. Yeah, it's okay to write, you know. Greetings to you too. I can see your name from here. But greetings to you too. Thinking of heading to the forest tomorrow. Climb a mountain and stuff. I actually do that when I'm on my free time, when I'm not parenting. I'm no David Goggins, but I'm like all for the wild stuff, you know, wilderness, being out in nature, climbing the highest mountains possible, traversing the deepest forests, like a manly man. We have like a snowstorm here in Sweden now, snowstorm. So I have to see how it is tomorrow with the weather. Might be going anyway if it's bad or not. I have my winter jacket somewhere. I need my winter shirt. Oh, I'm such a retard. I broke my whiskey fucking glass, you know, the tiny. Oh, stupid I am. If you hear that glass sound in the background. Oh my god, I have to put on my sneakers. I can't even see the glass. Yeah, my thighs. look at these. I think I can squat all of my viewers together, my subscribers, you know. I getting tired of the crown hood here. Putting it somewhere. You expect to see a CC probably like sitting like this. No, man, I'm sitting like this. Hello, I don't see your names from where I'm sitting. It's too small. So, hello. 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 Greetings. Anyway, I really appreciate the chance to share this here. I'd like to see that again. But now that I'm looking for it, it probably won't happen. Grim, I love it. Keep doing you. New greetings. Hello. Hello. Five people? Hi. Hello. Just broke my fucking glass because I'm stupid. Eight likes already? I just felt drained. My energy level was just non-existent all day. In fact, all week. I would wake up in the middle of the night. I don't know why. But there was this feeling I kept having. I can't really explain it. I know that sounds odd, but I just can't bring it to words. Maybe dread was the closest I could relate it to. Maybe that's too cliche. I don't know. People had begun to notice how tired I was looking. Dark rings around my eyes. Eyes that were more often than not bloodshot. I'd forget things. I'd lose my temper at odd times. I was a mess, really. After work, I came home and just dropped onto the couch. I didn't have any energy to do anything, really. I turned on the TV and flipped through the channels. I didn't even have the energy for that. I just left it on something and then I began to drift off, I guess. I don't really remember. That's when it happened. I was just lying on the couch. I remember opening my eyes and feeling strange all of a sudden. My arms had goosebumps, and I had a feeling of slight panic. I tried to get up, but I couldn't. Couldn't really explain why. My body just wouldn't move for me. Suddenly, it felt like there were hands on my shoulders. And something was holding me. Nobody down. Said anything new. Yes, hello.
I remember I kicked my leg.
But anyway, hello is hello, so that makes you confirm you're actually watching, and it's better than anything, you know. So. Oh, my leg. My foot, I mean. My foot, man.
My fur. It felt like fingers.
And as you can tell, I'm not a feminine crossdresser guy, you know. I'm like, I like walk like this.
Not details or anything. Just the faint outline of the face. With these deep sunk eyes, sunken cheeks, and a mouth wide open, like it was inhaling something over me. I couldn't catch my breath. I started to really panic, and that made me move more. I started moving my shoulders and my arms, trying to push whatever it was on top of me. I could feel it holding me, but I couldn't feel it when I kicked up toward where it should be. Suddenly,
my stomach looks humongous with this corset on it to wear it under the dress.
I can't explain it, but then I felt a little hungry.
I'm kind of chubby, but I'm muscular too, you know, like really thick, and I have huge upper body. For some weird reason, when I suck in my stomach and flex, I can't even see the definition of my stomach. It's so weird. I don't know how heavy I am in pounds, but close to, or no, 100 kilos. That's a lot, a lot. I tried to get up to call out, but I couldn't. Then the room began to spin, and everything went dark. That's when I woke up 3 hours later. I got my keys and ran out the door for my car. I can show you my big arms, man. My big arms. Apparently, I look pretty bad. They took me immediately. Look at these guns, man. This is why I'm called Pop-Up Bear, you know. And I could feel something normal. The doctors and nurses asked, what happened to me? What can I tell them? I didn't know what to say. After hours of not saying anything, that's when they had the psychiatrist come in. My story came to me immediately when that happened. It was work. I wasn't sleeping.
And even Papa Bear wants to feel beautiful sometimes.
I tried to make it sound as normal as possible. I don't know if the doctor believed me or not. They kept me for another 3 days, though. When I was released, it took me a long time to go home. I drove around for a while, went to a restaurant to eat, but I eventually made my way home. I sat there in my driveway, my hands clenched on the steering
wheel. Big Papa, El Papa Grande. Papa Grande. That's my name. Papa, otherwise. Fucking corset. Where the hell are you going, man? You need to keep my flap together, bro.
I drove 12 hours to my parents' house in Tennessee. I didn't know what else to do. I told them everything, the entire story, and prayed that I didn't sound like a crazy person. I must have, though, because my father, well, I don't really know what he thought. My mother seemed to believe me, and I stayed at my parents' house for a few weeks. That was that. I was moving immediately. I don't know what happened, but I wasn't staying in that house. As soon as I could, I had it up for sale and got my stuff out as fast as possible. We moved out during the day, and I spent as little time as possible in there. Things happened to the movers and my parents as well. Things would disappear in the house.
Nobody says anything.
Maybe that was because
you liked the video at least. Eight
I'm
people
sure
liked the video.
I didn't hide my fear as well as I should have. I moved back in with my parents after that, but I keep track of the house. Eventually, I was a married couple. Months went by and nothing seemed to happen. I still have nightmares. I still can't sleep at night that well. I don't know what happened. I can't really explain it. Nothing like that has happened to me since, and I pray that it doesn't. I never believed in weird or strange stories before. I'd always say that people were making it up or something. That was until something weird happened to me. That changed my life. Now I can't help but to think there's some truth in everything people encounter. Details might not be clear or whatever, but it doesn't mean it didn't actually happen. I was riding the train into Chicago. It's a great experience, it really is. And it shows you how people used to travel back before the invention of cars.
Mm-hmm.
People make fun of me for how much longer it takes.
I'm getting bored of this stuff because I'm not even listening anyway, so. No, I'm scared. Anoob. Yes, Anoob. I'm gonna put on some music in the background so it doesn't get as boring. So you can see my big guns here, man. Yeah, maybe a crossdresser and everything, but I like being strong. Beautiful, but strong at the same time. There's no excuse to be weak. Thornberries are dangerous. You shouldn't mess with the thornberries. Oh my god. One shot it, for fuck's sake. I have 51 HK life and get one shot it by a thornberry. Don't mess with the thornberries. That's the point of the story. Do not mess with the thornberry. And conversation. Oh shit, man. Oh my lord, that's one big ass thornberry. That's the biggest ass thornberry I've ever came across. Oh, help me, Lord, that's one big ass thornberry. And now I'm seeing my own Bahamut Terra Flare. I've never seen it before. One big ass thornberry. I have a sketch channel, you know, where I do voices and funny stuff, you know, stereotypes. In case you're wondering, I'm not just a crossdresser. That's not my identity. For fuck's sake, I'm much more than that. I'm fucking awesome, man. And I'm not humble either. I'm not pretending to be humble. Because anybody pretending to be humble is a fucking narcissist bullshit crapper. Oh no, it's the big thornberries all the time, man. Just the big thornberry king. I think I'm gonna lose, is it? I didn't know thornberries could get invisible. Thornberry King, I don't have AP, what sounds good, huh? I'm standing up playing video games because I can't sit still, you know. I might have ADHD too, you know, just not autism. Some kind of ADHD, ADD maybe. I believe I have ADD. I'm too passive to be ADHD. Too passive. But not passive in bed, bro, so don't get any ideas. I'm the Lord in the bed. The Lord. The Most High. Stay away from me. Stay away from me, Tom Berry. We don't tolerate the kind around here. God bless you, Tom Berry kid. Nej, vad fan, vad många Tom Berries då. Hela jävla tiden Tom Berries. Så mycket Tom Berry. Det var en jävla Tom Berry. Why would I need Kurag and I don't have the map? Quit getting your board. Oh my fan, 26,000 kronor. Det är så dåligt. Och här är det jävla hård. Han står. Så fan, vad hård han slår. Damn, boy. Sätt dig ner, min tunt. Nej, inte han igen. Helvete vad hårt han slår mig. Nobody's watching. I feel offended. I'm offended. I feel offended. Två jävla tombergis, hur fan ska det här gå då? Okej, sitt bra. Nobody's watching, I feel so offended. Kettle, ah, det kommer inte sluta bra med kettle. Äntligen dog den jävla. Finally, äntligen dog den jävla. Everybody's watching me. I'm offended. So offended. Actually watching again this week. Nobody writes anything. I can't see if anybody's written anything. Hello was the last message. Okay. Nobody's just hello, you're just watching. That's fine too. Something that first it. Thank you. No comment. No comment at all. She don't give us. They shut their pants, man. They got afraid. They were afraid of me. Think I'm scary.
Something Swedish, like Granny Golden. Ah, I missed it. I did miss it. Hey, go fast. Oh, you shoot the ship? Die, motherfucker, die. Don't mess with my sack. He's OP, man. Hello? Nobody says anything, everybody leaves.
to go near. Bottom. Oh, why did Ifrit have to go all out on me? 999. I was hit with 9. I got one shattered by not calm shattered, so that's better. This boss is impossible. How do we beat him? Okay. I felt OP for a long time until I fought Ifrit. Review my equipment. I need to review my equipment. Maybe I... Kaiser knuckles. I need something that drains, that absorbs fire damage. Thank you.
Yes. He gave me life instead. Yes, I know how to take him now. Figured out how to beat Ifrit, the most hardest one, super secret, and a mission with you. So I feel unstoppable, like an OP man, OP player. I outsmarted him. Yes, I beat his ass. Safe to pick because they can always one shot them. Oh man, I'm not even thinking I'm on live stream of God. Maybe I should sit like this. I normally sit like that, man spreading like hell, you know. Anything, just have pervs watching, probably fapping and stuff, not saying anything. Maybe it's hard to write with one hand, you know. Nobody has anything to say. Thank you.
tired. I'm beginning to nodding off on the live stream while gaming. I'm sorry, I'm so tired. Turning off the music, you understand my phone. Thank you.
or the wine cooler? Single person to watch me. At least I got like 10 likes in this video. Thank you.
I'm gonna lay down for a moment. Nobody says anything. Everybody's just afraid to say hi. I'm ending the stream anytime soon, so if you wanna say something, say it now. Huge eyes, man. They said it had 10 likes, then it went away, one. Did somebody undo the like? They got so offended or something? Are you offended, bro? Everybody's offended these days, man. Say something. Getting bored? Estoy aburriendo. Me estoy aburriendo. Jag börjar bli uttråkad. I'm getting bored. Jag börjar bli uttråkad på svenska. In Spanish, me estoy aburriendo. And not saying in Japanese. I'm not that much of a weeb. Coffee and I'm getting tired. Watching me. I like this stuff. I'm into the voyeurism stuff and the exhibitionism myself, so I like, I don't care who's watching me, you know. Still like it's fun to talk to people occasionally who watch the streams, you know. It makes it more fun, you know, than just talk by yourself. Feel like you're a split personality disorder or something, just talking to yourself all the time. Sissy, you know, like,
I got to my shed and I have such a beautiful image again.
No, I talk my real voice, you know. Dun, 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 dun. like this coming back. Singing words from, I mean words from anyone. It's always the same when I do this. Somebody just watches. Like, no matter what to say, I get, you know, get the balls on spine or courage to write. Or so. Should be doing other things than just live streaming and laying down on a bed like a lazy fuck. They should be working out, you know, like clogging style and just staying hard, man. Stay hard. Today's my off day. I always take it off. I mean, I take it off. Take off my. Oh, I can't speak. I have an off work day, you know. I mean, oh! I have one day when I don't grind, basically. That's today. Something. Hello, Elu. Elu. Yo. Sup? Such a troll. I'm like the biggest troll in the universe. At least I look like I look in real life when I live stream, and not like these fake fuckers that use the Snapchat and FaceApp shit everyone's using, you know. So many using that FaceApp stuff, it's so ridiculous. You can tell instantly that that's Hollywood filter effects, digitalized images. And it's always like millions of sims that are too stupid to even understand it's digitalized photos you're watching of either women or cross-dressers that use them, you know. It's so stupid, it seems like 10 IQ or 1. Don't be stupid, man. The sexiest thing in the world is intelligence and empathy, of course. Those two combinations together makes a beautiful human being. Everything else is just fake fuckery going on, you know. I have a foul mouth. I'm like cursing constantly, you know. Can't even help myself. Super difficult to think about it when I'm with my daughter, you know. Nobody says anything. Biggest eyes in the world, man. So I can see good in the dark.
Ask me anything, a question. My live streams are so, I know what to say, it doesn't happen much with my audience. Nobody has anything to say. Yeah, this is how the world is today. Nobody has anything to say. Just keep quiet and let evil be done and happen in the world. I have never anything to say. I have no opinion because they're afraid of everything. That it might be a reaction, a consequence, an action they might not like. So they just keep quiet, they just are good, silent fuckers, never say anything. And that's how the world gets overtaken by evil. Your inability to take action. I mean, yeah, I'm not like the other crossdressers that just walks around and do stuff like pretend to not be into the just being a fetishized thing, you know, sissification stuff. I actually give good knowledge and advice to you, but you don't appreciate it. Like the last one left now. Yeah, I'm ending this now. I won't be wasting my precious time on this crap. See you. We don't want to be you.